Hello, Damon Mercier. I'm going to take a look at S3 to tape at over 102 gigabytes a second and how that's possible. Just for comparison, an enterprise NVMe drive only writes at around 2.5 gigabytes a second. So what we're going to basically do is look at the numbers, but I'm going to do a demo using S3 browser on Windows, followed by a demo using Ansible to control 10 CentOS clients using S3 to write to the system. So the system is based on a software package from Point called Point Archival Gateway. You can store and manage volumes of several hundred petabytes. It also supports up to 8 tape libraries with up to 256 tape drives. So LTO 8 or 9 drive, and even the IBM Jaguar drives will write data at 400 megabytes a second. Being able to support 256 drives gives you the ability to write 102 gigabytes a second. And numbers, that actually expands out to 6.1 terabytes in a minute, 0.36 of a petabyte in an hour. Basically means in a 24-hour period, with the full complement of drives, you can write 8.8 petabytes to tape. Now that is also done without using any compression. So if your data is highly compressible, you can expect to exceed these numbers. So what we'll do now is jump into the system. We'll take a quick look here at the rack. You see we've got several servers and the quantum tape library. And if we actually now jump into the software, well, first of all, go over to the S3 browser, and then we'll come back and have a look at the Ansible software. Okay, thanks. So what we can do, take this forward, if I do a quick properties, you see it's actually 42.6 gigabytes. I can literally drag this into the Archival Gateway here. This will first of all hash them locally and then transfer them over to the server. We will also change over to the other server while that's running. Again, on here I've got a 33 gigabytes of data, 33.4, and this one I can also drag onto another bucket, and we'll see this one again will start hashing and uploading. See that they're running through. And we're actually uploading 16 chunks at a time here, or 16 files at a time. Okay, we'll change back to the other server. And here we can see this one's transferring away as well. So if we go over to the Archive Gateway, actually do here is connect up to the statistics. We should be able to see here on the actual node the rate the data is coming in at. So from a couple of servers here we're receiving data at 597 megs a second, megabytes a second, so 650 now. What we can actually then do is change over to the library. We can see here the data has been streamed directly out to tapes here. So both drives are writing this data out in parallel. Yeah. And obviously this is a LTO7 with a virtualized server powering the Point Archive Gateway. Production environment, so you would have a direct hardware without the virtualization. And we can actually see a light blip there in the throughput. In general, the data is being streamed through. And then, if we come back to the throughput, we see we're still taking data in at nearly 500, and dropped to 100 now. I think if we go back to the actual clients, see here, the one's just finishing up, just waiting for the server to acknowledge the completion there. And again, the other server is again doing the same. Okay, so slightly different here. Connected to our virtualization system, I've got XCPNG running, which is where the PAG server is actually running with the tape library connected. What I've actually got running in this environment is 10 CentOS machines, which actually got S5 or the S5 command for S3 upload. I've got a separate CentOS control machine. If I change on to this machine, we've actually got a Ansible installed and set up here. We've got a playbook, which is a set of instructions, which I've created here called YouTube. And if I actually run this, what this will do is instruct all 10 CentOS machines to upload via S3 using the S5 command to the point server. So let's hit return. Click on the window first and then hit return. You can see this is now actually kicked off. What this will have done is instructed all 10 machines simultaneously to start transferring the files. If we now change over to the PAG machine, what we'll actually be able to see here on the network, the connections dropping in and out and the data coming in. So we've actually got about 3.3 gigabytes on each of the 10 machines. So in essence, we're going to transfer about 33 gigs of data. It varies in size from a few megabytes up to about 1,000 megabytes. There. What we'll actually see here is the data coming in, and we'll see the number of connections. You can see there's sort of 20 connections closed. We'll see them starting up and running through, periodically updating. Again, if I change here over to the tape library, what we'll actually see is both of the drives will start streaming the data again through to here. Again, if I start the second drive, we'll be able to see in a moment as it will actually start writing. Okay, you see the first drive is writing there, about 136, 300. Second drive is also now starting to stream. What we can actually see is the performance is actually impacted very much by the client sending the data through quick enough to the system. As again, here we can see these both drives now streaming. Okay, we just go back over to the statistics. Let's have a look here. We'll be able to see the number of connections it's running through. The number of connections we've got accepted, the number that's been closed. I think we'll have a look here at the tapes. Still writing a second. Change over now to the control. And we can actually see this has actually finished here. And we can see all 10 machines have reported back that they've completed. Thank you for making it to the end of the video. Don't forget to like and subscribe. And if we can be of help to you, reach out to us through our website, mercia.solutions.